Let's go.
Yeah, boss.
I guess we should take another look at this cabinet color Mitchell revived from the dead. To be fair, let's look at it in the kitchen light. So imagine I'm entertaining, I'm cooking, I'm throwing out delightful quips to my guests. Be honest, does it wash me up?
These are the kind of conversations I snuck under the fence for? Is that funny?
Oh.
What's in my act? Well, I also do this bit, though, where I go to a lumberyard and I meet this hot girl.
Okay, I'm gonna stop you right there. If the punchline has anything to do with wood, you're better than that.
Yes, I chose to be entombed in a wall rather than admit to Cam that I was eavesdropping. And yes, I realize couples counseling should be back on the table.
This color Mitchell wants,
you don't seem to like it.
I don't love it, but he does, and let's just go with it because I want to make him happy.
Wow. My wife wouldn't even ask me. You're very nice. He's lucky to have you.
I'm the lucky one. Trust me. You know, we start every morning off in this kitchen, and I want us both to walk in here and see something we each love.
I do. I do see something I love. It's you.
Mitchell, oh. What in the hell? You were eavesdropping.
I'm sorry. I stand by what I said. Eavesdropping is wrong. I should have just asked Francisco myself. Why is it you call him boss and me Mitch?
Oh.
It's okay. Tell me. I can take it.
Well, I can't remember his name.
What?
Really? You know, I keep wanting to say Krang, but I know that's not right, unless it is.
It's Cam. Okay, we have spent every day together, Francisco. I'm a little offended.
Oh, well, if it makes you feel any better, my name's actually Fernando.
It does help.